Good afternoon, students. Hi, students. How are you? Are you fine, ma'am? I hope everyone is fine with God's grace, isn't it? Okay. Did you study previous class portions? I sent geography lessons, question answer, isn't it? Learn that question, okay, ma'am? So will you learn? Study thoroughly, okay? So okay. That continuation in previous class geography lesson in previous week I have started, isn't it? Geography first lesson, the universe and solar system, the universe and solar system. Okay, that continuation. So Earth is, we are living in which planet? Earth, isn't it, Pa? So the Earth is the third planet. Okay, it is the third planet from the sun. Earth is the third planet. This is globe, isn't it? It is the model of the Earth. Okay, so this Earth is the third planet from the solar system, from the sun. Okay, so and the fifth largest planet in the solar system. At the same time, fifth largest planet. Okay, fifth largest planet planet in the solar system. It is called the blue planet. Okay, have you seen it? Appears look blue color, isn't it? Okay, water has covered. Okay, so that it is called a blue planet or watery planet. Okay, ma. So because 3/4 of the Earth is covered by water. Okay, 3/4 of the Earth is covered by water. So the Earth is the only planet in the solar system which is not named after any Greek or Roman deity. Okay, so in this planet only has named after any Rome. Earth is the planet, isn't it? So we are not chosen this names Greek or Roman deity. So it is other planets and the maximum the what the Roman or Greek deity will be there. So it is the only planet known to support life. Okay, so in the this planet only we are living in this planet. It is supporting our life. Okay, so life is possible on Earth because of the presence of land. Why? Because at the present of land, okay, this is the land, isn't it, Pa? So seven continents will be there, isn't it? So in this land only, so we are living in this planet. So air and water also, land, air and water we are getting in this planet only. So the polar diameter of the Earth is 12,714 kilometer, and the equatorial diameter is 12,756 kilometer meters. Okay, so the diameter and equatorial meters and all I will explain later. The Earth revolves around the sun at the speed of about 30 kilometer per second. Okay, so it is speed how many kilometer per second it is? 30 per second kilometer. It revolves around the sun. So the only natural satellites of the Earth is the moon. Okay, so in our planet we are getting the natural satellite. Moon is the natural satellite. Could you understand, ma? Okay, so Earth is the third planet, isn't it? Third planet, at the same time fifth largest planet. Okay, so life is possible on this Earth, isn't it? Yeah, because land, air and water is sufficient at present in this Earth. Okay, then the speed also, you know that rotation and revolution also I will explain. So you know the map, isn't it? Equatorial. So you know that. Okay, so that I will explain in the map. If you have only, it is easy to explain this. Okay, so the distance between the sun and the Earth is about 150 million kilometer. A flying at the speed of 800 kilometer per hour from the Earth would take 21 years to reach the sun. Okay, so the distance between the sun and the Earth is about 150 million kilometer. Okay, 150 million kilometer distance it is. At the same time, you think it, students, a flight flying at a speed of 800 kilometer per hour from the Earth would take 21 years to reach the sun. How many years it reached the sun? 21 years. So you think it, imagine how it is. Okay, students, the next planet, Mars. Mars is the red planet. Okay, Mars is the red planet. So Mars is the fourth planet from the sun and the second smallest planet. Okay, it is the smallest planet in the solar system. Okay, if you have social book, you take your book, all the pictures has given. Okay, or the names plus whatever the picture also it's given superly. Okay ma, so if you have book, you open your book and learn. Okay ma, listen. So Mars is the fourth planet from the sun and the second smallest planet in the solar system after Mercury. Okay, so it is the second smallest planet. Okay, second smallest planet. Which planet is called the second smallest planet? Mars. Okay, Mars at the same time red planet. Okay, so it is named after the Roman god of war. Okay, so it is given the name Mars, isn't it? So it is a Roman god of war. So it appears red in color due to the presence of iron oxide on its surface. Okay, why it is in red in color means because it filled with iron oxide. Okay, iron oxide. So it is often described as the red planet. It has a tiny atmosphere. It also has polar ice caps like the Earth. Okay ma, so red planet, why ma, why it is called the red planet? Because it filled with what? Iron oxide. Okay, iron oxide. So it is called the red planet. At the same time, it is a type of atmosphere? Thin atmosphere. Okay, it's very thin atmosphere. So it also has polar ice caps like the Earth. Okay, so they have the caps also. Polar ice caps will be there in this planet. Okay ma, could you understand? So in this planet, Mars has two natural satellites, namely Phobos and Deimos. So many orbiters and rovers have been launched to explore this planet. Okay, so in this planet have two natural satellites. What are they? What are they? What ma? Two natural satellites, namely Phobos and Deimos. Okay, Deimos. Okay, Phobos and Deimos. So many orbiters and rovers have been launched to explore this planet. Okay, many of them went in this planet and did the research work. Okay, so that is Mars. The next is Jupiter, the largest planet. It is the largest planet. Okay, so Jupiter is the fifth largest from the sun. Okay, fifth planet from the sun. Okay, so not largest, fifth planet from the sun. This Jupiter. Sun and the largest planet in the solar system. It is named after the king of the Roman gods. Okay, maximum all the planets, all the this planet's names and all, it's based on the Rome gods or Greek gods. Okay, that names they fix that. Okay ma, but Earth it is not like that. Okay, could you understand ma? Okay, so it will be like this. So in this Jupiter is the fifth planet from the sun. Okay, at the same time it is the largest planet in the solar system. Okay, so it is named has given Roman gods. It is the third brightest object in the night sky. Okay, in the night you can see which planet? Jupiter. Okay, it is the third object, so bright it is. Okay ma, so bright it is, after Moon and Venus. After Moon and Venus, it is the brightest object. It is this planet. So it is the fastest spinning planet in the solar system. At the same time, it is very fast also. It's a spinning planet. Okay, so it is called a gas giant planet. Okay, so it's filled with what? Gas giant planet it is. It's called. So its atmosphere is mostly made up of hydrogen and helium, like the sun. Okay, so this Jupiter filled with hydrogen and helium. Okay, so like sun also filled with this. Okay, so Jupiter also it's filled with this. So it has the largest number of natural satellites: Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto are a few largest satellites of Jupiter. Okay, many natural satellites we are getting in this planet. What and all? Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto are a few large satellites of Jupiter. Okay, these are the satellites of this Jupiter. Then next one is Saturn. It's the ringed planet. Okay, it's a ringed planet. So Earth is the living planet. Mars is the red planet. Jupiter is the largest planet. Jupiter is the largest planet. Okay, ma. Then Saturn, ringed planet. Why means? Why everyone like ring, isn't it? So in this planet have one ring. Okay, outside it is. So ringed planet it is. So the Saturn is the sixth planet from the sun. Okay, in this Saturn have this. Okay, ring. Saturn is the sixth planet from the sun and the second largest planet in the solar system. It is the second largest planet. Which planet? Saturn. Okay, ma. So after Jupiter, it is named after the Roman god of agriculture. Saturn has many rings around it. Okay, in this Saturn have many rings. Okay, around it. Okay, so this one also it's based on the Greek god only. They have given this name. Okay, so these rings are huge and are mostly made up of ice, rocks, and dust particles. Okay, so in this ring is made up of ice, rocks, and dust particles will be there. So it's look like ring shape. Okay, so full and fully dust only, dust, ice, and rocks. It's full, it's covered. Okay, in the outside of in the ring side. Okay, then satellite in the Saturn has 62 natural satellites around it. Titan, Saturn's largest moon, is the only satellite in the solar system that has clouds and a dense atmosphere composed of nitrogen and methane. Okay, students, so how many natural satellites in this planet are receiving? 62 natural satellites. Okay, 62 natural satellites. Okay, ma. So the specific gravity of Saturn is less than that of water. Okay, so it is very less than that of water. Okay, which one is less than the water? Saturn. Okay, Saturn is the ringed planet. Okay, ma, Saturn is the ringed planet. Then Uranus, next Uranus, ma, Somer salting planet. Okay, Somer salting planet. In this planet, is the seventh planet from the sun. It is the seventh planet from the sun. So it was the first to be discovered with a telescope by the astronomer William Herschel in 1781. Okay, so first we have seen this planet, this astronomer's only. Okay, astronomer named William Herschel. Okay, William Herschel, in which year? 1761 only it is visible. Okay, they discovered this Uranus. It's a Somer salting planet. It appears green color due to the presence of methane gas. Okay, so if we can see this planet, it is look like a green color. Okay, why? Means its presence is filled with methane. Okay, methane. It is named after the Greek god of the sky. Okay, it is, has given the name after the Greek god of Greek god name. Okay, has given this. Then it rotates on its axis from east to west like Venus. Okay, it's rotating like a Venus. It's rotating. Rotating is. Okay, so its axis is tilted so much that it appears to orbit the sun on its sides like a rolling ball. Okay, while seeing time, the sun in the side it is. Okay, it looks like a rolling ball. So Uranus has 27 natural satellites, of which Titania is the largest. Okay, so it's they have 27 natural satellites. Could you understand, ma? Could you understand? Earth is the living planet. Okay, Mars is the red planet. Jupiter is the largest planet. Saturn is the ringed planet. Uranus is the Somer salting planet. Okay, ma. The next one is Neptune. Neptune, closest planet. Okay, coldest planet it is. Okay, Neptune is the coldest planet. Why? Means Neptune is the eighth and the farthest planet from the sun. It is the eighth planet. At the same time, it is very farthest planet from the sun. So there are strong winds in this planet. It is named after the Roman god of sea. Neptune has 14 natural satellites, the largest being Triton, because of its distance from the sun. Okay, so it is the fastest planet from the sun. At the same time, in this planet, they have a strong winds. Okay, strong winds. So the Neptune has 14 natural satellites, the largest being Triton because of its distance from the sun. Neptune is one of the coldest planet in the solar system. Okay, nothing students, Neptune is the coldest planet. Okay, it has received what, how many natural satellites will be there? 14 natural satellites will be there. Okay, ma'am. So it shrinks blue and white features of Neptune help to distinguish it from Uranus. Okay, so what color, ma? Have you seen, ma? Neptune, page number 165 it is. Okay, so it's look like blue color. Okay, it's receiving, this Neptune is receiving 14 has how many natural satellites? 14 natural satellites will be there. Okay, ma? So the name also has given to you, to your book. Okay, the next 168 one picture is there. Have you seen that picture? The planets at a glance. Okay, the planets at a glance. All the picture has given that day is also given. It's rotating because of the gravitational pull. Okay, clear, ma'am? Okay. Then the dwarf planet. Okay, dwarf planet means what, ma'am? So already I informed you many million years ago after the Big Bang explosions, what happened? It blasted, isn't it? Because of that reason, some of them grew, some of them. Differently it is in the space, it is, isn't it? Asteroids, meteors, dwarf planets will be there, isn't it? Solar system, I explained before, up to this is the how many planets will be there? How many planets, ma'am? There are 9 planets. There are 8 planets, okay, in the solar system, isn't it, students? 8 planets in the solar system. So, you know, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune, isn't it? So, Mercury, 4 planets are called what? Inner or terrestrial planets, isn't it? So, remaining 4 planets are outer planets. Outer planets are Jovian planet. Yes? Inner planets or outer planets, okay? Totally there are how many planets are in the solar system? 8 planets in the solar system, okay, right? So, so in the dwarf planet, this also it is in the space, okay, students, but it is not in group, okay, but they have, clear? Dwarf planets, okay, so the dwarf planets are small celestial bodies found beyond the planet Neptune. They are extremely cold and dark. Okay, in this planet, what it is very cold and dark also. They are almost spherical in shape. Okay, so what shape it is? Spherical in shape. So, but unlike planets, they can share their orbit with other dwarf planets. The 5 dwarf planets of the solar system are Pluto, Ceres, Eris, Macmade and Haumas. Okay, Pluto also considered before and the 9 planets will be there. Okay, Pluto also included. But later the astronomers informed the Pluto is a dwarf planet. Why means if this Pluto is what they are doing now? They are sharing the orbits to other planets. Okay, they are sharing the other orbits to other planets. So Pluto is considered as a dwarf planet. Clear? Clear, students? Dwarf planet means water. They are sharing the orbit to other planet. That's all. Clear? Clear, students? So, Pluto also considered as a dwarf planet. Okay. So, 9 planets will be there. But the Pluto is not in the solar family. Okay. So, it is in the space only. But what? It is in the... calculated in the dwarf planet. Okay. Dwarf planet. Dwarf planet means what is the speciality of the dwarf planet? They are sharing the orbits to other planet. Okay, that is that. Clear, clear? So, the 5 dwarf planets of the solar system are Pluto, Ceres, Eris, Macmade and Hyumium. Okay, so these are the dwarf planets. The next, the moon, Earth satellite. It is our Earth satellites. Okay, moon is the Earth satellite. Which revolves around the planets. The moon is the Earth only satellite. Okay, so the moon is the only Earth satellite. The moon is the Earth only satellite. So it revolves around the Earth once in the year, 27 days and 8 hours. Okay, how many hours it revolves around the Earth? 27 days and 8 hours. 8 hours. So it takes about the same time for it to complete one rotation around its axis. It has no atmosphere. The surface of the moon is characterized by craters created by the impact of meteoroids. So the distance between the moon and the Earth is about 3884 kilometers. The size of the moon is 1/4 of the Earth. Okay, so nothing, students. So it is the natural satellites we are receiving water. In this moon, water is the natural satellite. So it revolves. How many days it's taking? 27 days and 8 hours. Okay, 27 days and 8 hours. Okay, so the surface of the moon is characterized by craters created by the impact of meteors. The distance between the moon and the Earth, the distance also has given, children. So the moon is the only celestial body where humans have landed. Okay, you know, Neil Armstrong, isn't it? Has landed in this, place. Okay, so you know, asteroids. Next I will explain asteroids. Asteroids are small solid objects that move around the sun. Okay, so asteroids is the small small solid objects that move around the sun. They are found as a belt between Mars and Jupiter. They are too small to be called as planets. So they are also known as planetoids or are minor planets. Okay, so asteroids means what, ma? It's a small solid object. Okay, so small solid objects, that's all. It's move around the sun, asteroids means. Okay, it's move around the sun. Okay, clear? Then comets. Comets is a celestial object made up of head and a tail. Okay, this one also, it's a one of the celestial body. The tail and the head will be there. Okay, so like how means what? The not it is that it's tail. The picture has given to you. Okay, if you can see, you can see clearly. So the head of a comet consists of solid particles held together by ice, and the tail is made up of gases. Halley's comet is the most famous comet, which comes close to the Earth every 76 years. It appears in 1986 and will appear in 2061 meters. Okay, so Halley comet will be the, okay, comets means what? They have head and tail eaters. Okay, so it appears in some years only. Okay, many years later only it will be. So last what? 1986 it happened. Then later 2061 it will be. Okay, we can see this type of comets in the space. Okay, ma'am? Could you understand? Then meteors and meteoroids. Okay, so a meteor is a stone-like of metallic body which when entered into the Earth atmosphere, most of them burn. Okay, so meteors means what? It's a stone-like metallic body. Okay, it's a small stone-like it is. Okay, so in this, what it will happen? No, sometimes it will burn. Okay, sometimes it will burn in this meteors. So as they often appear as streaks of light in the sky. So they are also known as shooting stars. While seeing in the seeing this meteoroids and meteoroids, what like striped light it is. Okay, light, it's a striped light it will be. Okay, so it just look like a shooting stars. Okay, so shooting stars. This meteoroids and meteors and meteoroids will be there. Okay, students. So meteors which strike the Earth's surface are called meteoroids. Okay, meteoroids. So that means what, ma'am? In this striped like line it is, isn't it? So that is called what, ma'am? Meteoroids. Okay, could you understand? Could you understand? I'll do this enough. Remaining portions I will teach you later. Okay. Okay, students. Then today I will give the question answer. Today study portion is question answer. Okay, you should learn this. Learn the question answer. One words also, if you get time, you can learn. Okay, ma'am? Okay, so will you study this? In this week, fully geography lesson, you can study. Okay? Okay, students, if you have any doubt in the Zoom meeting, in the Zoom class, you can ask to me. Okay? Thank you, students.